Hi friends, welcome to day 3 to solve UPSC prelims questions 2017. Today we are going to deal with sections history and science and technology. I'm Uma Maheshwari and I have cleared civil services exam 2018. To know more about me, please pass the slide and read the info. Let's begin to win. Question number 1. The painting of Bodhisattva Padmabani is one of the most famous and oft illustrated paintings at. This is a hotcake question and any UPSC aspirant would be well known about it if they had read the basic NCERTs. And the answer to this question is A. Ajanta. You can see this is the painting and this will be actually given in the NCERT Standard 11 book. The Bodhisattva is holding a Padma, which is a lotus. Question number 2. Consider the following pairs, traditions and communities. Chaliha Sahib festivals, Hindis, Nanda Raj Jat Yatra, Gons, Wari Varkari and Santals. See, when you get some Ladu questions, you also get questions like this, which are very tough. If you are not aware of the facts, please do not attempt such questions. Now let's find out the answer. Actually, the Chaliha Sahib is the festival for Hindis, which involves devotees fasting for days. And the Nanda Raj Jat Yatra, it is actually celebrated in Nanda Devi temples and the festival commences on the day earmarked for the Devi's visit to her parents' home and ends with the return to her husband's home. And Wari Varkari is a Maharashtrian festival celebrated by the Marathas. The Palakis carrying the Paduka, that is the footprints of various saints from the Varkari sect, are taken from their respective shrines to Pandharpur. The answer for this question is A, one only, because Nanda Raj Jat Yatra, it is not by Gons and Wari Varkari is also not by Santals. Question number 3. Which of the following are famous for sun temples? Arasavalli, Amarkantak and Omkareshwar. Actually, sun temples are not located at Amarkantak and Omkareshwar. There are very few sun temples which are famous in India and Arasavalli is one among them in Andhra Pradesh. The answer to this question is A, one only. See, this is Arasavalli sun temple and there are other important sun temples which are Konark sun temple in Odisha, Modera sun temple in Gujarat, Suryanar Kovil in Tamil Nadu and Marthan sun temple in Jammu and Kashmir. Question number 4. With reference to Manipuri Sankirtana, consider the following statements. It is a song and dance performance. Yes, this is correct. Cymbals are the only musical instruments used in the performance. Let's look at it. You see, this is the picture of it. Not only cymbals, there are some drums. Drumming also is going on. So, statement 2 is definitely wrong. It is performed to narrate the life and deeds of Lord Krishna. Yes, this is absolutely fine. This is correct. So, the answer to this question is B, which is 1 and 3. And the Sankirtana is one of the few important heritages. It is also inscribed in UNESCO's representative list of intangible cultural heritage of humanity. Now, the task is for you to memorize all the 13 intangible cultural heritage just in UNESCO's list in India. Come on, fast. Pass the video. Question number 5. With reference to the religious history of India, which of the following statements are correct? Again, one tough fact-based question. In history, such questions are asked repeatedly. I really desire to meet the person who takes questions, especially in history part in UPSC. And number 1, Sautantrika and Samitya were the sects of Jainism. No, it is wrong. Actually, they are the sects of Buddhism. Sarvastivadin held that the constituents of phenomena were not wholly momentary but existed forever in a latent form. Yes, this is correct. The answer to this question is B, 2 only. You can see, the Sarvastivadin sect of Buddhism believed that all things exist and exist continuously in the past, future as well as in the present. The main three sects of Buddhism are well known, Hinayana, Mahayana and Theravada. Question number 6. Which one of the following was an important seaport in the Kakatiya kingdom? ruler Ganapati was the most powerful in the Kakatiya kingdom, and Motupalli was the seaport at that time, and Marco Polo visited Motupalli. Question number 7. With reference to the difference between the culture of Rigvedic Aryans and Indus Valley people, which of the following statements are correct? Actually, Rigvedic Aryans used the coat of mail and helmet in warfare, whereas the people of Indus Valley civilization did not leave any evidence of using them. Yes, this is correct, because no such defense equipments were found in Indus Valley civilization. And Rigvedic Aryans knew gold, silver and copper, whereas Indus Valley people knew only copper and iron. Actually, this is wrong, because Indus Valley people knew copper, silver and gold, but they did not know iron. And thirdly, Rigvedic Aryans had domesticated the horse, whereas there is no evidence of Indus Valley people having been aware of this animal. Actually, there are a difference of opinion in this statement. Some people tell that Indus Valley people were aware of horse, but according to UPSC, this is actually right. That is, Indus Valley people were not aware of this animal, which is horse. So the answer to this question is C, 1 and 3. Question number 8. Who among the following was or were associated with the introduction of Rayatwari settlement in India during the British rule? What is Rayatwari settlement? That is, collection of revenue directly from the individual cultivators. And actually, Lord Cornwallis is associated with permanent settlement system and not Rayatwari system. And Alexander Reed and Thomas Munro. Yes, they both are associated with Rayatwari settlement. And hence, the answer to this question is C, 2 and 3. Now, the new system was tried on a small scale by Captain Alexander Reed, and it was tried in the areas which were taken from Tipu Sultan after the war, and later it was tried by Thomas Munro in the entire South India. Question number 9. In the context of Indian history, the principle of diarchy refers to another hot cake question. If you are aware of Government of India Act 1919, this question is very easy for you, and the direct answer for this question is division of the subjects delegated to the provinces into two categories. Actually, the two parts were transferred list and reserved list. In the transferred subjects, the governors were to be assisted by the ministers responsible to the legislature, while in the reserved list, the governors were to be advised by the councillors who were not accountable to the legislature. Question number 10. With reference to Indian freedom struggle, consider the following events. This is another hotcake question, and such easy questions were asked in modern India. That's great. Actually, Rin mutiny was in 1940s. Quit India movement, any aspirant would have known it. It is 1942, and the second round table conference in 1931. So the answer to this question is the correct chronological sequence. So 3, 2, 1. Yes, it is option C. Question number 11. Consider the following pairs. Radha Kant Deb, the first president of the British Indian Association. Yes, this is correct. Gazulu Lakshmi Ramasu Chetty, founder of Madras Mahajan Sabha. Oh, this is wrong. This question can be answered only by very serious UPSC aspirants who have recorded all such organizations and the names. And Surendranath Banerjee was the founder of Indian Association. This is absolutely correct. So the answer to this question is B, 1 and 3. Yes. The British India Association was established in 1951, and it was by Raja Radha Kant Deb, Kali Krishna Deb and Devendranath Tagore and others. And in Madras Mahajan Sabha was established by Veera Raghavacharyar, Subramanya Iyer and P. Anandacharlo in 1884. And the India Association was the first declared nationalist organization founded in British India, and it was by Surendranath Banerjee and Anand Mohan Bose in 1876. Question number 12. The object of the Butler Committee of 1927 was to Actually, the princes of the states feared that their states may get into the government, that is the British government's hand, and hence to improve the relationship and to clarify the relationship between the government of India and the Indian states, Butler Committee was appointed in 1927. The answer to this question is D. Question number 13, the Trade Disputes Act of 1929 provided for. Will your options A, B, C or totally wrong? The answer to this question is D, a system of tribunals and the ban on strikes to settle the industrial disputes. Question number 14. Consider the following statements. The Factories Act 1881 was passed with a view to fix the wages of industrial workers and to allow the workers to form trade unions. Actually, this statement is absurd. To improve the working conditions of the industrial workers, actually, Factories Act 1881 and 1891 were passed. Actually, Lord Ripon introduced the Factories Act of 1881 to improve the service conditions. The Act banned the appointment of children below the age of 7 in factories. It reduced the working hours of children. It also made compulsory that all dangerous machines in the factories to be fenced properly to ensure the security of workers. I also have read in some other book that the Indian industries were flourishing at that time, and so such conditions can restrict their productivity. Because this Factory Act is applicable only to Indian industries and not to the foreign industries, that is the British industries, British owned industries. And the second statement is N.M. Lokande was a pioneer in organizing the labor movement in British India. Yes, this is correct. So the answer to this question is B, 2. Actually, there is one more part in today's video. Please do watch it. Thank you.